Hello guys, welcome to today's video. In today's video, we will talk about L'Oreal Paris Rare Flowers Cleansing Facial Gel. Now, this is the gel, as you can see. Now, this gel is meant to be used on your face, but you can use it all over your body if you want. This gel is without alcohol, and this gel is without perfume. Now, with L'Oreal, we see something new in the high street with their brand. I think that here they stole something from CeraVe and their fragrance-free and alcohol-free products. As you know. Now, on the bottle, this cleanser says that it is for dry to very dry and sensitive skin. It claims that it can soften your skin, smooth your skin and cleanse it very well. Let's go first with the positives. Now, this cleanser is not a typical gel cleanser. It's most like a milky jelly cleanser or something. It is gorgeous. It foams very well. I really like it, and it really cleanses my skin very well. I'm not sure that this product will be suitable for skin that use a lot of makeup, or with people that use a lot of makeup and that are outside all day with reapplying SPFs or mineral SPFs especially. I really like it. This is not a typical gel cleanser as you imagine, but this is more like a milky texture, jelly texture, and it is wonderful. With the ingredients list, there are some really good ingredients in this cleanser, and let me check it. Ingredient in the ingredient list is aqua or water. This is with almost all of the skincare products. And the second ingredient here is really gorgeous. This is glycerin. If you watch my previous videos, you maybe know that I am in love with glycerin. It is a wonderful humectant. It really holds the water molecules in your skin, on top of your skin, and it is a natural moisturizing factor. This means that you already have it on your skin and in your body, and it is really wonderful with keeping the moisture and the water in your skin and really moisturizing it and hydrating your skin. Now, I think that glycerin here serves as a really hydrating ingredient to compensate if something, if some dryness occurs during cleansing or after you cleanse your skin. Now, after glycerin, there are some really mild surfactants. This means that they are most of the new generation surfactants, and by new generation surfactants, I mean that they are made maybe around 2000 year or something. The first of the surfactant is disodium concocoa amphoxetate, and the other surfactants are cocobetaine and sodium lauryl sulfate. I really like this type of the surfactant complex in this cleanser because they used really mild surfactants. For example, cocobetaine or disodium cocoa amphoxetate, it is really mild, and you have to search for this word cocoa. This means that it is maybe derived from coconut, or maybe it is made in a laboratory, but in this type of technology. This means that they are milder, they're not aggressive, they don't take away any of your lipids on your skin, and they cleanse your skin very well without making it really dry, itchy or red or something else. Then we have sodium lauryl sulfate. This is not sodium lauryl sulfate, this is lauryl sulfate, and this is something like in the middle of the mild cleansers or something. I don't mind this type of surfactants, nor I mind sodium lauryl sulfate, because I don't have a problem with them, as long as they are compensated with some really hydrating and moisturizing ingredients. Now, in the next of the ingredients list, we see the stars in this cleanser, and their jasmine flower extract and rosa gallica flower extract. Now, with this type of extracts, they are maybe a potential allergen or something, but as long as you don't have an allergy to this, maybe it is not a problem. This cleanser, as I said before, it is fragrance free, so this type of extracts here don't serve a purpose like a perfume extracts, for example tea tree water or something that gives the whole formula some fragrance. You have to bear in mind that Rosa Gallica can be used for her astringent properties, that mean that it can dissolve oil. Basically, let's talk about jasmine. Jasmine is really one of my favorite flowers. I really, really like it in terms of fragrance, and when it is in fragrant composition, it's really, really calming or something. But in this cleanser, it doesn't have a smell. It is here for it has maybe some potential humectant properties. Maybe hold some water in or something, and really maybe some potential antioxidants activities also. Other good ingredient in this type of cleanser, this is sorbitol. Now, sorbitol, it is a type of sugar, and maybe you know that sugars are really, really good in holding the water in. Basically, they are humectants. Now, let's go to the form and formula of this cleanser and the texture basically. Now this is the bottle. As you can see, it's 150 ml, so I think that it is pretty economically good. It is how do I say it? I don't know the word.
My mind, oh, it amazes me sometimes. I should have an octane level.
But, it will last you a long time, maybe something like 2 months or 3 months, I don't know, it depends how much you use. The texture of this cleanser, I really use maybe just a little bit more of this is not enough, maybe, I don't know. As you can see, the texture of this cleanser is really, really like some milk or runny or something, as you can see, but it foams really, really well. It is really gives you this type of luxurious feeling. For example, as you're using some really high-end brand like, I don't know, French pharmacy or something, it is really, really fabulous. And maybe you know that L'Oreal has La Roche-Posay and CeraVe, and I think that they here they combine the glamour of La Roche-Posay and effectiveness and clear formula from CeraVe. Basically, this is really, really good cleanser, and I really strongly advise you to try it, because it's really nice, and I'm sure for the most of us, for the most of you, you will like it. Now, type of skin that this cleanser is good for. I think that this cleanser is good for all types of skin. Now, maybe for example, if you are a little bit more oily, like super, super, super oily, maybe you will need to use more of this or use it 2 times. Or if you use a lot of sunscreen and a lot of makeup, for example, with powder and foundation and all that jazz, maybe you will have to use an makeup removal and or a oil cleanser and first cleansing step or something. This wine, Rare Flowers by L'Oreal, has I think 3 or 4 types of products. It has a cleansing cream that it comes something like a Pond's or something, but it's not like that. It's more like a toilet cream milk. I don't know is it the exact term, but it comes with 400 ml. And basically, you dab your fingers in the product, and you can use a cotton pad or something and then wash away, or you can just stay with it these days in the bottle. The other product in this wine is, I think, clearing toner, tonic or something. It's again makeup removal too. And the other type of product, I think it is a cleansing milk, if I'm not mistaken. But I think that this one is really focused on cleansing your skin, really soothes dry skin and sensitive skin, and I really think that it is good. Now let's go to the not so the good side of it, but it isn't something really that you should worry about. First is that it may be not suitable, or it may not cleanse your skin if you wear a lot of things, as I said before, like a makeup. The other thing is that here maybe some people can experience some type of allergy if they have sensitivity to jasmine, for example, because I think that rosa gallica is not in very big quantity, and that is the negative side of this cleanser. But all in all, I think that this is the really really good product that you should try. This is a high salary product. It is you can find it in drugstore, for example, or pharmacies or something. The price point of this product is really really fabulous. It is something like 4 to 7 euro or something for 150 milliliters, and this is really the bomb. You can beat it. It is fragrance free, as I said, alcohol free. It doesn't have some colorants in it, like strongly colorants. It has one that gives it this luxurious white texture, but nothing serious or something. And I really hope that you can give it a chance and try it, and then you can tell me in the comments below. Now that was for me for today basically. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up, share, subscribe, and comment down below if you want. Bye.